And of course, we can't finish off the hour without giving you your update about the fall of UA. It's been almost 1 month since the horrific terrorist attack, and today we have moved to a confirmed death count of 67 after Yayorozu passed away in the ICU this morning. Police are trying desperately to find someone with a healing quirk powerful enough to restore Kirishima to a conscious state. If you or someone you know may have a quirk with the capability to assist in Kirishima's recovery, please contact the UA Help and Recovery Hotline. He's one of the only chances of learning just what happened at the source of the explosion as the only remaining survivor in Class 1A. After Endeavor's retirement following the death of his son Todoroki, everyone's eyes seemed to be on X-Zone, who cancelled his vacation to return to the line of duty as the new number one hero. He's been very public asking for privacy about his son, who has become disabled after being caught in the collapsing building. There is still an Amber Alert for a boy whose identity is unknown. Police have been sharing and pushing this picture out into the public. He was spotted during the attack by multiple sources. If you see this boy, the Federal Department of Hero Regulations has asked you dial 911 immediately to contact law enforcement and give the location, as well as try to memorize any faces that you see who might be with the boy. Police have also asked people to keep an eye out for this man, who has earned the name the Hand of Mercy. An overwhelming amount of students said that he was incredibly helpful in assisting them out of the building, and they thought he was a hero during the attack. However, footage was uncovered of him slaughtering a student Arav in a single punch. Due to this, he is thought to be incredibly dangerous, and law enforcement has asked if you see or hear anything about the Hand of Mercy, you flee to a safe location and contact law enforcement after you are safe. UA students who have been displaced are expected to return to regular high schools next week all across the city. They have been invited to join the Quirk Trade School Southview, if they so decide to, for the second half of their day where they'll be taking a bus during their lunch periods to attend with students from all across the city. The transitional period is expected to be a little bit rough, mainly since Southview doesn't focus on hero work. They attend part-time during their high school careers, and at the age of 18, less than 20% of the student body is known to go on and pass the hero provisional exam and become sidekicks or interns in the hero industry after high school. With majority of UA students already having their provisional licenses, there's no telling what sort of dynamics this may cause. The president of Southview has said they are going to try their best to help UA students thrive moving forward the school year until a better solution is set in motion for these children that will be more permanent. Southview will be celebrating the arrival of UA students today by hosting a fighting competition. UA students are welcome to attend for free if they bring their old student IDs. The event organizers, all students from Southview, thought this might be a nice way to have UA students introduce themselves and meet some new classmates, as well as inspire them with positive hobbies that might help with the recovery process. The Combat Club from Southview will be the ones competing, and the Cooking Club has offered to provide refreshments. Tickets for general administration will be $15, and this fundraiser is going to assist with UA merging with Southview as they become one.